In the latest Continuum 2025 maintenance release, we've included three new features in our popular Moton Blur ML filter driven by AI. Let's get a sense for how we can create pristine, stylistic looks on fast-moving footage. I'm here inside of Premiere Pro, and I just so happen to have sped up this moving train shot. Just so that you can see this, I'm going to hop inside the nest, and we take a look at that. I've added BCC plus Retimer ML, increasing the speed of my clip to 500% using this AI-driven effect. Hopping out of the nest by closing it, I've also applied Moton Blur ML, which is adding an extra layer of motion blur to my now sped up clip. This is controlled by just a few parameters, but most notable is the shutter angle and shutter phase if you're just starting out, which will allow you to mimic real world cameras and get the desired look. Now in this shot, I'd actually like to limit the motion blur. It's applying it to areas that are fast moving and also areas that are just a bit more slow moving. I'd like to have those areas in focus. We can now limit this with the limit low motion parameter. I'm going to enter a value of 5, which refers to pixels. And you'll see here that the area of the train, which is further back from the camera, slower moving, is now a little bit more in focus and less affected by the motion blur. If I increase that limit low motion amount even further, I'll set this to 15. We now have a much wider range that is unaffected by the motion blur, again, because it is slower movement. This is also great to visualize with a few different output parameters that we've added to Moton Blur ML. So if I come over here to the output, I'm going to change this over to motion vectors. So in the maintenance, we've added this, which allows us to see the direction that our vectors are moving in. This happens to be both. And to get an even better view, we can set this to 150%. I want to also just focus on the back area of the train, which we've now limited with low motion. Look what happens when I reset this parameter. We'll see that the blur is now introduced to that slower moving area of the train. We can see the vector in both directions, both forward and backward. If I go to direction and just change that to forward, now we notice the forward moving vectors. If I set this to reverse, we see the reverse moving vectors. And last, now back to both. Once we increase the limit low motion, we'll see that the vectors aren't adding motion blur to this area in both directions because less motion blur was applied to this area of the shot. Now, in addition to this output, we also have a speed map. This is a black and white mat that allows you to see what's moving fast and what's moving slow within your image. We'll go over to speed map and I'll just play this shot full frame. It's a sped up shot using Retimer ML on these motorcycle riders. If I exit out of full screen and we go into the Moton Blur ML effect, let's change the output in this case to speed map. Our image changes. And as we take a close look, you'll see that as objects move closer to the foreground, they are moving faster and identified by white. Things that aren't moving as fast are identified by gray, and things that aren't moving at all would be identified by black. This is great to look at when you're in comparison mode. I'll just do a side-by-side where I can see the original shot of the motorcyclists compared to the speed map and how fast things are moving within the shot. Just like we did when we were viewing the vector's direction in output, with our speed map, we can see how limit low motion, which is currently set to 12 on this clip, will have an effect when it's set to 0, noticing more areas are coming into white and gray, where motion blur will affect those areas. We can now see that by just switching over to motion blur and toggling between that and the speed map to dial in just the areas we want affected. In addition to using speed map as a visual guide, we can also use it to drive the limitation of effects within Continuum and Boris Effects Suite. I have a tutorial just for that that you can check out. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe and check out additional content at borisfx.com.